Have you ever heard of Saab? Saab AB is a Swedish aerospace and defense company, founded in 1937. Saab produced cars from 1947 until 1990, when the automobile division was spun off as Saab Automobile, a joint venture with General Motors. The joint venture then ended in 2000, when GM took complete ownership. The basic initial development of the firm was the Swedish government's problem of getting quality military aircraft delivered at the beginning of the Second World War. The final trigger was the inability to get many jet deliveries from the United States. The Swedish government focused on establishing a domestic production and development of military aircraft, and Saab took that challenge from then on, a policy that has continued to these days. The main focus of aircraft production is fighter aircraft. Saab has been making aircraft since the 30s, and their most famous model is the Gripen. The Gripen is at the center of the story that sees the agile approach as a useful way to build aircraft. Let's start with a simple consideration. The cost of defense procurement seems like a complex number to contain. With the US spending hundreds of billions of dollars on projects that, compared to the initial estimate, often end up with budgets more than 60% larger. With the will to change this situation in the defense world, Saab developed the Gripen E in the early 10s of the new century using an agile method. Now, let's see how. How could a company focus on large, complex projects like military jet development and production think about moving to the modern agile practices? During a project to upgrade an old version of Gripen, the software development teams started using Scrum, effectively becoming the incubators of agile for the entire organization. In the development of the Gripen E at this point, Scrum became the reference framework for the whole project, and not only for software development, but also for the hardware part and for the aircraft design. The original framework has been enriched by other models and practices, such as lean development, Kanban, extreme programming, and some typical traditional project management practices. Before we get into the details of how they run the businesses, let's talk about how they run the people. First of all, the numbers. They involved more than 1,000 people working on this project, divided into more than 100 teams. Numbers definitely different from the typical Scrum project. This was made possible by a particularly agile approach. Each team was able to independently choose the level of agility best suited to them and their activities, under one condition: to respect the pace of the sprints. 3 weeks. Just talking about sprints, can you imagine 100 teams, and therefore 1,000 people, who clearly and precisely follow the Scrum? That's it. We would risk having daily stand-up definitely too long. Given a steady pace with 3 week sprints for all the teams, the process has been reviewed. A high level of alignment is needed across teams, and strategic vision and interdependencies across phases. For this, a project master plan was defined, and that, iteratively, was divided into development steps. Phases with clear functional objectives that typically ended with a test aircraft. These development steps serve to synchronize the various disciplines of the project and achieve the same goal together. Each step is then divided into increments. The increment is a quarter with specific goals, within which there are 4 3-week sprints. The goal of each increment are defined in a mixed manner, using a both top-down and bottom-up approach. In addition to the process, Scrum has also evolved significantly in terms of roles and ceremonies to define a true hybrid process capable of achieving the results expected from such a complex project. The product owners are each referring to 4 to 8 teams, working as always on the backlog, but focusing much more on risk mitigation, especially on the integration of the various teams. Product owners, even more so than in a traditional project, stand in for a customer who is unlikely to be involved in this type of project, but to improve the process, the pilots were involved very frequently. In terms of ceremonies, a system of meetings was created to identify team-level dependencies and show them to the entire project team. Retrospectives, which are left over from a traditional Scrum approach, have a clear focus on continuous improvement of the overall project approach. They then introduce the retrospective of retrospectives to spread common solutions to common problems and bring them to the entire organization, aligning all together. You may be wondering, how was this possible? Well, compared to the more traditional approach to projects like this, some things had to change. In the initial phase, in the setup of the project, there was a strong push on the modularization of the architecture. This had a direct impact on the organization. Each team was clearly tied to a module. Given the particularly costly and time-consuming nature of this project, Saab has worked hard on creating state-of-the-art simulators to have much faster feedback loops and assess the impact of design choices. The strategic plan obviously remained, but it became a document that was in its nature alive and used as a point of contact between the various product owners. This video is built on the article Owning the Sky with Agile, Building a Jet Fighter Faster, Cheaper, Better with Scrum by Jorgen Furuhjelm and Johan Segertoft, Project Manager at Saab Aeronautics, and Joe Justice and Jeff Sutherland of Scrum Inc. Sutherland is among the creators of the Scrum Manifesto. The article was released in 2015 and is available in the description below this video.